Hello dear students, I hope you all are studying properly. Well, today in this video we are going to understand the poem Racing the Wind by Michael Clover, which is given in your English reader book on page number 31. So before we recite and understand the poem, let us understand the summary of the poem. The poem Racing the Wind by Michael Clover is about a boy and the wind who decided to race. The boy said to the wind to blow a crisp bag and race back to the starting line. While racing, the crisp bag got lost and the wind kept on finding that crisp bag. Finally, the boy reached the starting point and the wind lost the race. The wind was very unhappy at the loss and he huffed and puffed and gruffed all around and kept searching for the lost crisp bag. So isn't it a very interesting poem that a race is going on between the boy and the wind? So before we start reciting the poem, let us understand the word meanings which are given in your book. The first word is invisible, which means that cannot be seen. Next word is crisp, which means potato chip. The next word is crumpled, which means crushed. The next word is dashing, which means going somewhere very quickly. The next word is huffed and puffed, which means breathed in a noisy way because was very tired. The next word is gruffed around, which means sounded rough and unfriendly. Now let us understand the poem. I said to the wind, I'll race you then to that gate there and back again. But the wind said to me, how will we tell which of us won? I am invisible. So I thought and then I found a crisp bag crumpled on the ground. I picked it up and said to the wind, you blow this and I'll just run. So off we went, me and that bag, dashing like mad, not once looking back. But when we got there, the bag went on, bouncing, flying right across the playing fields till it got lost. Well, I raced back to the starting line, shouting, I've won. Your bag can't run in a straight line. The wind just didn't know what to say. It huffed and puffed and gruffed around, rattling the chimney pots all day, blowing across and round and down, searching for the bag it lost. Yes, so let us see the poem's description once again. I said to the wind, I'll race you then to that gate there and back again. But the wind said to me, how will we tell which one of us won? I am invisible. So I thought and then I found a crisp bag crumpled on the ground. I picked it up and said to the wind, you blow this and I'll just run. So off we went, me and that bag, dashing like mad, not once looking back. But when we got there, the bag went on, bouncing, flying right across the playing fields till it got lost. Well, I raced back to the starting line, shouting, I have won. Your bag can't run in a straight line. The wind just didn't know what to say. It huffed and puffed and gruffed around, rattling the chimney pots all day, blowing across and round and down, searching for the bag it lost. Yes? So I hope you have understood the poem very well. And now you need to learn and recite the poem well. All right. So thank you so much, students. Bye-bye and take care.